2018. I've been on the air now. Oh, I forget how many years. But anyway, it's been a lot, and I'm so glad to be talking to you all this evening here on channel. Well, there's so many channels, I can't remember them anymore. But anyway, this is our Oscar prediction show, my favorite show of the year. And this year, I'm trying something. I'm really going out on a limb, and look who's here. David Kaufman, the critic of critics, who just happened to walk in. Anyway, he's going to sort of help me through this as if I needed any help. But thank you, David.
Thank you,
well,
Stephen.
Yeah, let's not give Poland Water too much of a plug. So let's start with my favorite category. If you could read the names of the nominees for Best Supporting Actress.
Best Supporting Actress is Allison Janney in I, Tonya, Laurie Metcalf in Lady Bird, Octavia Spencer in The Shape of Water, Mary J. Blige in Mudbound, and Leslie Manville in Phantom Thread.
Okay, this is a very complicated category, believe it or not, to discuss. I don't know if you... This is the year of the woman. Were you aware of that?
Yes, in many regards.
Well,
actually,
in Hollywood, when they sit down to make out their, you know, ballots, they're doing it right now, the first thing they're going to think of is what's been happening, you know, and how all of the hubbub has all sort of centered on this film called Lady Bird. Have you seen that?
I have not seen Lady Bird yet, unfortunately, but I would
add...
That the prediction is that many of the presenters...
Well, let's save the predictions
and the nominees are going to be wearing black.
Tonight at the Oscars.
At the Oscars,
too.
Yes.
I say, well, I mind wearing black. Well, anyway, I want to be in solidarity, but I have to say that there's this whole thing about... And Greta Gerwig has been a guest on the show. She's been lovely. She's adorable. So smart. Brilliant film. But it's about high school. And so it seems inconsequential. However...
She's the director of Lady Bird.
And she wrote it, too. You know, she's not in it. She's a wonderful actress, but she's and a comedian, and she's not in this. I don't know if it's going to win anything, except perhaps here for Laurie Metcalf, who plays her mother quite brilliantly. I mean, I think it's the best thing she's ever done. You know, she's Roseanne's sister, and she won the Tony last year for Roseanne Part 2 on Broadway.
Well, it was A Doll's Life Part 2, but...
A Doll's House Part 2. But anyway... Laurie, we love you. Be on the show. Anyway, okay, I think you're going to, even though Allison Janney, who I adore, and I knew from when she lived in New York and she would invite me to things, she moved out to L.A. and did the West Wing. I never heard from her again. Anyway, that's what happens. But she's very, very popular in L.A. But I, Tonya is a toxic movie, I think. Have you seen that? No. It's not necessary. You don't have, you can skip it. Tonya Harding was just this... She started tabloid news almost. This horrible girl, ice skater, was behind the whole Nancy Kerrigan attack. And the movie sort of is explaining, well, it was really her mother who drove her to this. And that she says she has nothing to do with what happened to Nancy Kerrigan. Yeah, right. So I guess on moral grounds, I object to this movie. And many in Hollywood might, too, who will remember, because the Academy, you know, is older than... We are any, so therefore,
but
Laurie,
I gather it has to be seen for Allison Janney's performance.
No, not necessarily. I'm sort
really?
Of doing it right now. it's very one note, and she screams the whole time. Let's move on to the next category. How about that?
Okay. The nominees for supporting actor in a film are Sam Rockwell in Three Billboards Outside of Ebbing, Missouri, William Dafoe in The Florida Project, Richard Jenkins in The Shape of Water, Christopher Plummer in All the Money in the World, and Woody Harrelson in Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri.
Thank you, David. So, this category is a joy because Sam Rockwell, I think, is going to win. Have you seen Three Billboards?
I have.
Well, what did you think?
Well, I was surprised by how funny it was. I mean,
yes.
It's really a comedy. And as you were saying before about Alice and Janney, I was actually a little underwhelmed by McDormand.
Frances McDormand. Oh, dear.
McDormand. I was underwhelmed, actually.
Well,
she's usually so terrific.
Well, let's not
but
go there.
She was kind of doing shtick, I thought. Anyway, but the movie itself is wonderful, and Sam Rockwell is great. So
Sam is...
But Woody Harrelson is not bad either.
No, you're making me choke, David. Woody Harrelson is not going to get it, but Sam Rockwell is, and I've known Sam since he was a young person going around all. He's been on the show a couple of times too. I once interviewed him in bed, and I noticed that he had this tattoo on his. Well, I don't know which show. You know. And I just said, oh, "What is that?" And he said, "Oh, it's a hanging cock."
Why did you interview him in bed?
Oh, this, we were on the set of the play he was in, so. He was, it was lovely. And one of those historic things, the tapes that I can't find. I've been looking and looking. Anyway, Sam plays the most complicated part of all of the people who were playing parts in this category. This is the most complicated in that, and we can't reveal how, but he goes through an arc. Fran's been on the show too, Francis McDormand. And I, you know, and you know this because of the theater. In England, you know, Martin McDonagh, the filmmaker, is a playwright, really, an Irish playwright who has written some of the greatest plays of our time.
The Beauty Queen of Linnaean. In fact, there's a play on right now at the Atlantic, and there's talk of its transferring to Broadway.
Of course it will,
called
too.
The Hangman. Which I'm seeing tomorrow and reviewing, in fact.
Oh, do you need anybody to go with you?
I already have some, unfortunately. Sorry, Steve.
All right, well, and I'm putting you on my show. This is how it goes. This is how my life goes, folks. I do it for you. Anyway, I just loved Three Billboards. I saw it twice. I was so taken up by it, and I don't want to give any of the no spoilers.
It does have its dark side, like all Martin McDonagh plays. I mean,
you know,
there's a lot of violence, and
I heard that it's a rumor, but that he had some kind of incident in his family, that a violent incident that may have driven him
I've
to write.
I've heard that too.
Oh, okay, it's true then. If David says it's true, it's true.
I didn't say it's true.
I can't believe we're doing this. This Siskel and Ebert from the Dead Act. Anyway, Sam, congratulations. He's 50 years old. He doesn't look it. He looks exactly the way I didn't
realize he was 50.
He was the video clerk in my video store in the 80s. I mean, just, you know, he's been around, and he's been kicked around a lot, and he used to... I remember him being in these incredible depressions about his acting
Didn't Tarantino
career.
Also begin as a video clerk in
yes,
the video store?
Yes, he was there all the time. Sam just went in and out. He just couldn't stand it. And I think he became a waiter or something, or a bike delivery person. But meanwhile, he was always complaining about his agent, a guy at the time. But now he has a woman, and I think he's doing quite well.
Obviously.
He's going to never stop working now after this, so... Good luck, Sam. I remember you. I hope you remember me. Remember that bed, Sam? Next.
And the nominees for Best Actress are Frances McDormand in Three Billboards Outside of Ebbing, Missouri, Saoirse Ronan, Sally Hawkins in The Shape of Water, Margot Robbie in I, Tonya, and Meryl Streep in The Post.
Thank you, David. I think they should just have a category for her and just put her in it every year without all the nomination stuff. I mean, of course, she was brilliant, you know, but she's not going to win. I think it's Frances McDormand, and you didn't. You thought she was doing shtick.
Well,
she was incredible. It's one of the great screen performances of all time.
I thought she was doing Fargo again. I mean, it just seemed very similar to me.
Well,
she's wonderful, I've seen her on stage often, and she's one of the best actresses. She's divine.
She is one of the great actresses of our time.
There's no question.
They've got that wrong with sticking it on Laurie Metcalf. It's Frances McDormand. Frances hates doing publicity, but she was on my show back in the day. Such a cute young girl. And now she's 60, and look what she's doing. I think it's fabulous.
Which Coen brother is she married to?
Joel. And doesn't the film seem like a Coen Brothers movie?
Completely, completely.
How did that happen? Nobody talks
well,
about
Martin
this.
Well, Martin McDonagh's sensibility is kind of similar. I wouldn't say equivalent, but it's kind of similar to the Coen Brothers sensibility.
Well, we all love the Coen Brothers when they're on it, which is when they're serious. When they start doing comedies, it's like, get out of the room! Anyway, Frances is probably going to win best. Saoirse is the only other thing that could upset with Lady Bird, but I don't think so. They usually give it to the cute young girl in this category, but Frances' performance I just thought was towering, and I didn't think she was doing
You don't think Sally Hawkins is in the running?
Well, no. I wish she was. It's just Frances is such a juggernaut. There's so much momentum behind Three Billboards, and they're going to give it something big, and I think it's going to be Frances and Sam, and they call her Fran, so if you see her, say, hi, Fran, you know, and she'll talk to you. But she doesn't talk to the press. She did one interview, you know. One for this
I
movie at the New York. You read it in the New York
I
Times,
did.
Yeah, and in the T section, and it was, you know, an incredible interview about how she didn't want to give interviews. So, and she was on the show, and she wasn't even married to Joel then, and she came in with this kind of striking looking, colorful watch, and I asked her about it, and she said, "Oh, this is my significant other gave this to me," and of course, it was Joel Coen, even way back in the 80s. So, yeah, she went to the Yale School of Drama. She auditioned barefoot.
And my memory is the Coen brothers went to NYU.
Yes, they sat in the back and didn't talk to anybody, I was told. But anyway, just generalized hostility. Maybe just from Ethan rather than Joel. Ethan's son has been on my show, whose name is Buster. Hey, Buster. He'll never live that down in Provincetown. I didn't know he was Ethan Coen's son. And Frances and Joel have a son that they've adopted from, but who's old, you know, who must be an adult now, who was from South America. But anyway, Frances McDormand. Okay. Next.
And the nominees for Best Actor in a Leading Role are Gary Oldman in Darkest Hour. Timothée is how Stephen tells me he pronounces his name.
That's the way the
Chalamet in Call Me By Your Name. Daniel Day-Lewis in Phantom Thread. Daniel Kaluuya in Get Out. Denzel Washington in Roman J. Israel, Esquire. And that's it.
Yes, that is it. And this category is going to be very short because it's pretty open and closed. That the magisterial historic performance by Gary Oldman as Winston Churchill will probably win for The Darkest Hour. Did you see The Darkest Hour?
I did.
Oh, wow.
And I'd agree. I mean, he was. Magisterial is a good word for it.
Everybody's done Winston Churchill. Well, nobody's done it as well as he's doing it. It's the best one ever, and it'll never be done this well again. And Joe Wright directed it, who I know. He did a fabulous job in keeping it's all about Winston Churchill. And, you know, I think I asked him or somebody did, you know, why is the focus just so on Gary's performance? And the director, Joe Wright, said, well, I felt that anything cutting away from that story, that performance, was unnecessary. And he was right. Let's go on to the really complicated category.
Best Picture of the Year. And they're 9 this year, which is really a lot. 3 Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. The Post, The Shape of Water, Dunkirk, Lady Bird, Get Out, Call Me By Your Name, Phantom Thread, and Darkest Hour.
Well, this is a very confusing category because, you know, I have my sources, of course, at the Academy. And they're all completely confused. Everybody's voting for different things, and a case can be made for almost every one of those films, except perhaps The Darkest Hour isn't going to win. I particularly thought, did you guys see Phantom Thread?